Students, welcome back. Let's continue with the subject compiler designs. So let's see the topic of type checking. So what is a type checking in compiler design? So where this type checking module will be present? Okay, at what stages the type checking will be considered? Let's see the topic. So a compiler must check the program follows the type rules of the language. So whatever the compiler you are taking, while it is compiling the program, it has to follow the type rules of the language. So each language is having their own type rules. So based on the type rules, the compiler has to be checked. So the information about data types is maintained and computed by the compiler. That we know that. Okay, so the information about the data types like integer, character, float, all the data types is maintained and computed by the compiler. So what's about this type checking? The type checking here, a type checker is there, which is a module. A type checker is a module of a compiler. So in the compiler, you are having one of the module that is a type checker devoted to type checking task, which is useful, helpful in type checking task. Type checking task. So what are the tasks here? So what do you call this task? The task here is nothing but the index is allowed only on an array and index must be present. So the operator has means a different rules each task. The integer means the range has to be in this way, and the float means that the value of float will be assigned to the value of floats only, like that. Okay, so that is the tasks, different tasks. If you take indexing, so where this indexing concept will be used? The indexing concept will be used only for the arrays, like that. Indexing is only for arrays, to assign the array values. So that is the tasks, different tasks. Okay, so the thing is, actually the compiler, the information about data types is maintained and computed by the compiler. So here in the compiler, you are having a type checker module. So this type checker module is going to be devoted to type checking tasks. So it is maintaining some type checking task. What type of task it's going to be maintained? So whenever you are using the indexing concept, this indexing will be used by only the data types arrays, like that. So let's see the introduction part of this type checking. The type checking may be either a static or dynamic. A type checking may be either static or dynamic. Okay, so the static is done at the compile time. It is done. A static checking is nothing but a compile. We can run the static checking is done at compile time, whereas dynamic means the dynamic it's done, the type checking will be done at runtime, done at runtime. So these points you have to be remembered. So type checking static means it is done at the compile time. Type checking will be done at the compile time. And whenever you are taking the dynamic concept, the type checking will be done at the runtime. So if you take the language like Pascal and the C, type checking is primarily a static. The Pascal and the C, whatever the languages you are using. So those languages in there, the type checking will be done only at the static position. Okay, and is used to check the correctness of the program before it execution. The main purpose of this type checking is it is whether the program is maintained correctly or not. Everything will be checked before its execution. So the static type checking is also useful to determine the amount of memory needed to store the variables. Okay. So let's see the design, how to design the type checker. The design of a type checker depends on the design of a type checker is depends on what concept? So it depends on the syntactic structure. Syntactic structure of language constructs and the type expressions of language, the type expressions of language, and the rules for assigning, that is the semantic rules, the rules for assigning types to construct. So these are the steps you have to follow to design the type checker, and the type checker always depends upon the syntactic and the syntactic structure of a language constructor and the type expressions of a language that you are using and the rules, that is the semantic rules for assigning types to constructor. Let's see where this position of the type checker in the compiler. So exactly where this will be present. Let's see the position of type checker at compilation. So while compiling the program, where this type checker module will be present? I said it is a module, so which is useful to check the program before execution when it is in performing in a static operation. Okay, so the position of the type checker will be okay, so here this is the flow from one phase to the another phase, and here the token streams are passing from lexical analyzers to the next, the syntax tree, and this is also in the form of syntax tree, and the final you can write, that's it. So here the token streams, that is from lexical analyzers, will be sent to the parser. The parser will generate a syntax tree. So whenever the program is converted into the syntax tree, that's a source language is converted in the form of syntax tree, there the type checker will play a role. So by seeing the syntax tree, so whether the each data type is handling the correct variable or not, so the type checker will check again if any modifications are there, it just modify it, and again it produces in the form of syntax tree. Now here the intermediate code generation is there, intermediate code generation. Okay, so after you will get an intermediate representation. Intermediate representation. Okay, so this is how this is a type checker is going to be play a role in the compilation process. So it's just take this token streams, enter into the parser. The parser will generate the syntax tree. So after generating the syntax tree, the type checker will check whether it is following the syntactic structure of language constructor or not, and the type expression, it checks the type expressions of the language, and it also checks the rules for assigning the types to constructor. So this is about the type checking. Thank you.